NIP going to be over on the blue side. And it looks like Hellseeker Reds on the red. And to go honest for you guys who might not be familiar with these players for the Hellseeker Reds, we got BBR playing Lucio Exceed on Pharah. We've got Ruape over on Reinhardt, Epix on Ana, Prettywise on Zarya, and Woomera on Tracer.
All right, well, we do have the first kills of this first fight getting underway. Zappas finally able to get the better of Exceed and gets Ana right at the same time. So two kills from Zappas, and he's going to be the main driving force. There ends up at four before it's all said and done. It was a really long back and forth of poking here, though. Both teams really taking their time, and finally Zappas able to thread the needle and get what he's looking for. And that is my cell phone alarm going off, so Jason, take it away.
It sounds beautiful. But either way, we did actually have this matchup happen yesterday, though, in the upper bracket finals, where we took pretty much just three games is all it took for NIP to take this victory against the Hellseeker Reds. It was Route 66, Hollywood, and Lijiang Tower. We will be seeing Lijiang Tower and Route 66 in the map pool yet again. But that's more towards the end, though. That's actually the last two maps of the map pool. But either way, Ruape being actually pressured quite heavily. Mafu up to 90 charge. Able to help take him down with the help of Himsy. Not really a chance you're going to survive off of this one. And so far, it's just a bloodbath. I think Hellseeker Reds, I think it stands for the blood that they're bleeding currently in this match, because NIP are just walking all over them.
Well, one thing that Hex brings up a lot when we talk about NIP, and it's very true here, is that NIP is one of the most aggressive teams in the game. They go out of their way to take fights on their terms, and the only way of dealing with it is to engage on them before they engage on you. But difficult task to do indeed, and look at how well set up NIP is for this next fight here, Jason.
I mean, I can only give, like, some criticism just because of the fact that you have Zappas on the low ground instead of the high ground, but, I mean, the Graviton Surge and the way NIP are playing right now, they're allowed to get away with maybe some missteps or misplays in this kind of situation. But again, he's staying close to his team, which makes it a little bit harder for Exceed to take him down. And they get another pretty much solid wipe here. So, Hellseeker Reds, and they go back to the drawing board. 20% left to go here on this first point. And with the Nano Visor already ready to go, I don't know if they're going to have what it takes to take this point back.
They do have at least somewhat equivalent resources here, but it's going to be difficult. This is their final shot of turning this round around, or they will be losing this round. But here we go, Prettywise coming in with the Groudon Surge. Going to pull in two immediately. Sets up Woomera for that big bang. Woomera gets Himsy from that. Only kill here thus far. We have a Nail Boost, and Tracer is immediately taken out by 76. Zappas coming in there does not care about how charged up your Tracer is. And the rest of NIP able to swarm in and finish off the last few remaining kills. So initiation coming out here from the side of Reds, not going to be enough.
And this doesn't seem like Mafu even cares about having any health, because he's sat in about 20 HP for the longest time in that fight, even blocking out the Earth Shatter, for himself at least, with his own personal shield. And that'll be the first point of Ilios going over to NIP. Now, let's be blunt here, ZP, because I feel like we're in a situation where we should be. NIP are probably considered hands down the favorites in this series. The fact that you've already seen them play once against each other, NIP is also one of the best European teams. And teams have not been able to figure out how to beat NIP necessarily, but if we were to look on the side of Hellseeker Reds, where would you kind of put the effort to be in? Like, who would need to really have a standout performance here?
Well, I think certainly to deal with NIP, normally for teams you'd say, oh, just have a better DPS game. I think it's more on their tanks right now, where you're going to have to put it on players like Ruop and Prettywise to have the tank games of their lives to deal with how aggressive and how in-your-face the NIP tanks are. The NIP is defined by their tank game, and we saw in part in that last round just how aggressive they can be in setting up the rest of their team.
Well, we do have the Widow v Widow battle at least coming in here between Mafu and Exceed, which we did have Exceed do just earlier on and yesterday up against NC Esports, but neither Widowmaker has really been able to connect with Zappas and Himsy. So this is one of the few times we're not seeing NIP play the triple or quad tank setup, and it's not seeming to be going too well for them, actually. Now that I look at it, the kill feed has been pretty much all red.
You have to go really far back to find a time where NIP was regularly not running at least triple tank. They ran triple tank before it was meta, and obviously it served them as it has been meta, but for now, they're sticking with the setup here, which involves a Widowmaker and a Genji, so we'll see if Mafu can get a little bit of wrench here, but Himsy tries to go forward, immediately gets bopped by Epix, and NIP thus far definitely looking a lot more mortal when not running the triple tank setup.
It's something Hex and I talked about quite a bit, is that when you do have Widows, it's so important to have that control of the point, which allows you to play further back and get off a lot more free shots. Whereas attacking, you're kind of too clumped together, and the focus is too much in your direction before you can actually hit too many of these bullets. But so far, Mafu at 91% on his ultimate, they're actually able to jump in with Fragge straight for Exceed to take him down, and Zappas getting slept, then smacked down as Mafu's trying to support from the back.
This is some really old-school Mafu action. There was a point where he was defined by playing Widow in almost every game. Gets the first two kills here, but it's still not clean here for NIP. In fact, Woomera able to get to the back line, takes down Mafu, and Exceed Hardy back in and finds Himsy once more. So NIP despite a few decent early picks there from Mafu, not really able to put it all together. And Red's playing much better here against the less than conventional NIP lineup.
Mafu, though, he does have an infrasight up, so Exceed's gonna be really hard for him to go for a clean pick. You're gonna see Mafu just waiting, just staring directly at his location every time he does peek around this corner here. But Zappa's getting close to his blade. Problem is, Zupe doesn't have the nano available because he just switched from Zenyatta over to this Ana. But there we go, Zappa's coming from the back.
Zappa's the backline, Blade is unleashed, looking for the Ana to begin with. Actually looks confused, loses sight of the Ana for a moment, does finally find her, but uses the entire duration of Dragonblade to do it. And while that's going on, the rest of Reds dove the backline of NIP, so Zappa's right now still trying to bring it around, but not the cleanest Dragonblade. And now the Reds, one team fight away here from taking this round.
It's getting really dangerous for them now. They need to kind of start to come back in this one. The fact that they won the first point of Elias so convincingly, and now at 97%, they have to get Solon to the point ASAP just to contest it. I don't think they're even gonna have the opportunity to. They're trying to get that man on top of it. It's gonna be Fraggy. He's gonna get there, but he's pretty much by himself.
Fraggy, the world against them. The world will win. Mafu coming in, 100 HP. MIP has shifted back to their normal composition here, but they are bleeding out players. They're not gonna get a chance to fight as six with the setup here, and they will lose the ruin stage here on Ilios. So MIP definitely experimenting a little bit there, and the experiment wrought with failure.
You know, I feel like they're pretty confident in general when it comes to, I mean, winning tournaments. I think they realize, yeah, I already won the series once just yesterday. I think you can try a couple of fun things. Maybe they're trying to please some fans out there, but either way, yeah. If you're NIP, you obviously don't want to show any weakness in your team, and maybe showing that comp and showing that you can't necessarily play it to level that like maybe the Koreans can or some other teams that are known for it can, does show you're a little bit mortal when it comes to having to play away from that tank setup.
NIP is definitely going to be dealing with a versatility crisis as time goes on right now, because they're very comfortable in these more traditional tank setups here, where now this is more their style, where they're going to be running with three tanks and Zappas into the air as Pharah. But at some point, NIP is going to have to learn how to play 2-2-2s with the best of them. And right now, I don't know if they can do that. But the first fight here is underway, Jason, and we'll see if they have an answer to Zappas in the skies, if Exceed can punish him.
Yeah, it's all about Exceed hitting these shots, and well, there you go, he catches Zappas out just in a split second. He's connecting some follow-up shots on Azupe as well, and the majority of NIP is just not looking healthy here as Exceed gets his second kill, and Fraggy, yeah, he's going to be able to respawn onto one, but do they have the HP left to pick up quite a few more kills, or just the people left alive? And it looks like they do, because Exceed isn't there to really help out. The lines that he's drawn don't really help when they fight inside this lighthouse, but that big contest is coming in for the first point. Finally, though, NIP, actually, finally, that was relatively quickly considering some of the games we've seen of capping the point over.
Well, particularly with Exceed getting those early pickoffs, but Zappas immediately nopes out of Pharah, decides to go, I'm just going to be going 76 instead. 76, harder for Widow to take out. Although, not impossible if the Widow is good, but Fraggy, early charge on the Rop, setting up NIP well here. Already a 6v5 advantage. Zarya way out of position. Pretty Wise will be dying as a result. It does, two kills do go to the backline from Lumera, but MIP is still a little bit in a better position right now.
And Exceed still on top of the lighthouse, is trying to make something happen, but the problem is they know he's here, so any direction that he's go, any kind of shots he goes for, he maybe will get one max, and they'll be able to turn around. And just as I say that, he gets like three off, and no one looks in his direction. But not really be able to capitalize too much off this. He needs to get kills pretty much by himself, because his team is so far back, he can't really have any follow-up from his teammates to make any kills really happen. So looks like he's just going to back away, and I wouldn't be too surprised to see a switch coming in from him soon.
And a switch would definitely make sense, especially as we get a little bit deeper into this round here. Only about two big attempts left here from the Reds, maybe three if they die quickly on one of them. So they're quickly running out of time right now. Look at NIP, being aggressive here once more. Fraggy going in deep. Earthshatter up and out the right. Will he drop the hammer right now? Already two kills. He doesn't need to, but he does it anyways. Finds both supports. Crunches one against the wall, and that fight going in favor of NIP.
And NIP just got knocked over the building completely from that charge, and just like the first two maps, the first 2 points so far on Ilios, it looks like it's just going to be 100-0 at this rate, because we have the Graviton Surge and the Ho-Hog ready to go on the side of NIP. And over for Helsinki Reds, they just don't have anything. And going back to a term, you know, Hex used, they just don't have enough meat on the ground to really deal with what damage NIP can put out.
Well, there's certainly a lot of meat on the bone right now for the NIP side. And Mafu, holding on to that Graviton, can easily end any push that the attackers come up with here, but they have to go in. They go into that vortex, and Fraggy's in, swinging the hammer as fall through. But look at them! Wumera in the backline, got both supports with the Pulse Bomb! There is still a possibility of this going the way of the side of the attackers, but it's not going to happen. Himzy and Fraggy able to have to clean up. And NIP are going to be taking round three here over the Reds.
Yeah, and it was a good Graviton Surge into a good Pulse Bomb. The problem was, you kill the two supports, but then you still have three tanks still left alive swinging at your entire team. And they shouldn't have the follow-up damage after that. They had to commit too much to pick those off, and they didn't really have solid damage. Like, Woomera was the only real big damage dealer for the team, the consistent damage dealer for the team, where they had Exceed on the Widowmaker, who had to hit these really hard shots to make anything happen. And it's going to take a while for him to really melt down a tank. So, yeah, you got the supports, but unfortunately for you, it's just not going to be enough. But still, they were able to pick up a point on the Ruins. We'll be going back on the Ruins yet again here, so can they go for that early point hold again? And will that allow Exceed to get, you know, set up on his perch to make these kills happen?
Well, at the very least here for the Reds, this is a little bit of good RNG. We are getting into round four here, which means that you repeat a stage, and it repeated the stage that they won pretty decisively. But you take a look at the composition that's coming out here from NIP. NIP going far more standard than usual with a 3-2-1 setup. Himzy, or Zapis on the Genji, the only switch up. And with the early hook on the Woomera, this is already looking far better than NIP than the last time around, geez.
Yeah, Himzy, he's doing pretty good here. I mean, those two hooks, two kills, pretty much nets in that first hold point. And not to mention Exceed, yeah, 28% ult built up, yes, but you can't really do much without a frontline team. And even Zapis is now just on the hunt, just lurking off towards the side, waiting for an opportunity to jump on top of this Widowmaker. And Exceed doesn't know he's there, so this could be some clean kills, finally able to turn around. And Zapis ideally should not be dying in this situation, but he takes the perch away from Exceed, most importantly, takes away a lot of different angles, and allows NIP to hold this up front position.
Zapis is gracefully getting in there, throwing out fan of shurikens after fan of shurikens, and Woomera not able to deal with the pressure there. Gets taken out by fire on all sides from NIP, and Exceed, the pressure that's on him right now is stopping him from getting those sightlines, as you just mentioned. And NIP, their unchecked relentless aggression really working out here, but they only seem to be able to do it when they're running with three tanks. But hey, it's a style that they've run more so than probably any other team in the game.
You know, I wouldn't be too distraught if Exceed switched like over to Pharah maybe in this situation. Yeah, it'd be a little bit harder to deal with Zapis, but you can get the high ground control, you can get the scouting in to show where the enemy team is for yourself and for your teammates. But meantime, Frag is getting nano boosted and charge won't connect, but it'll still be swinging that hammer.
All right, Earthshadow coming down here from Ruop, does knock down two and sets up Woomera for the Pulse Bomb. I'm not sure if it's gonna be enough though. Himzy still alive and unchecked. Zapis still lurking in the wings with the Dragon Blade. So despite some very key pickoffs, the Reds have not really won this fight here just yet. Zapis still looking to get help, has to be able to get it. Himzy with Craig here, effectively in a two on all in the point to start things off here. And with Fraggy going down, Zapis does find health. We'll see if he can come in with the Dragon Blade. Dragon Blade is out, looking for Exceed. Gets a little bit juked out, finally gets on the Lucio, still gets juked out, and immediately melted down by Zarya. So not the Dragon Blade he was looking for.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's about the second time. We haven't seen necessarily a great Dragon Blade out of him so far. But definitely, I mean, I even lost track of where Exceed went in the midst of that too, so can't really knock him too hard for that one. But now Exceed's been able to set up. This is where he could potentially become very dangerous, though there's not a lot of low HP targets for him to hit. A little bit hard to hit Kaino, which he's already been able to do once, but at least hit him into the head. And that's going to be a Graviton Surge coming through. It looks like Mafa's going to be saving his, though, while the rest of his team goes down. Force out some ultimates out of the Helsinki Reds.
And that is also a mark of experience, though, coming out from the side of NIP, where Mafu doesn't usually throw ults away. I think a lot of teams, as we've seen, sometimes will panic and try and save a fight. NIP is pretty good about knowing when to fold it, and Mafu folded there, which means NIP is going to still have the ultimate up for the next attempt. And look at this, the Sinky Reds giving NIP a taste of their own medicine, Jason, going very aggro onto them, not letting them set up.
That's good Earth Shatter too, and Zapis even has FX, you know, very low on HP. He's just not able to pick up the kill just yet, as he does get tagged up as well by Exceed, who's just trying to dash away, but with one health left, there's no real chance for him to survive. Even the bio grenade coming in just to stall for some extra time here, and Zapis is gonna have to back away. But with that kill, they take away that threat, they take away the sniping, and even BBR just trying to escape from Himzy, who just barely misses that hook.
Nanoboost coming out here from the side of NIP as they dive in onto the point once more. Zapis going in the Ana with Fraggy. Fraggy perhaps being a little bit more effective in swinging the hammer there. But NIP, they know what they need to do here, Jason. They should be able to recap this point. And if you look at the progress, there's still the case where they only need to win one more fight after this win. And oh my goodness, Zapis coming out the Dragon Blade here. I don't know. Was that really needed, Jason?
I don't necessarily know if it was needed, but I think they wanted to at least lock that one down and also prevent it from getting much higher in terms of percent for the side of Helsinki Reds. Because if it did get a little bit higher, the chance of them being able to contest before they finish the map would be a little bit too difficult. But I want to point out as well, Pretty Wise, he got two Graviton Surges before Mafu's used one. And that kind of shows that Mafu's been a lot more hesitant, a lot more careful in his use, like you said before.
Well, here comes a Graviton now from Mafu. He picks up not one, but two supports with that Graviton. Absolutely taking out the healing backline of the Helsinki Reds. And now, Exceed moving forward, looking for a pickoff. Not going to have a whole lot to look for, but has Lucio in his sights. Gets Kindle with that quick shot. Gets Ana. It's a two-pick here from Exceed, but Fraggy drops the hammer, takes him out. A nice last effort from Exceed, but unfortunately, just too many of his team were dead to really make that happen.
Yeah, unfortunate for him, but he definitely had a better showing towards the end of that one. And that was the map they won before, but at least they did take it relatively close. They built up to about, what, 84%, if I'm not mistaken, with Zappas and Himsey. So this is one of the few times we're not seeing NIP play the triple or quad tank setup. And it's not seeming to be going too well for them, actually, now that I look at it. The kill feed has been pretty much all red.
You have to go really far back to find a time where NIP was regularly not running at least triple tank. They ran triple tank before it was meta, and obviously it served them as it has been meta, but for now, they're sticking with the setup here, which involves a Widowmaker and a Genji, so we'll see if Mafu can get a little bit of wrench here, but Imzy tries to go forward, immediately gets bopped by FX, and NIP thus far definitely looking a lot more mortal when not running the triple tank setup.
It's something Hex and I talked about quite a bit, is that when you do have Widows, it's so important to have that control of the point, which allows you to play further back and get off a lot more free shots. Whereas attacking, you kind of have to come together, and the focus is too much in your direction before you can actually hit too many of these bullets. But so far, Mafu at 91% on his ultimate, they're actually able to jump in with Fraggy straight for Exceed to take him. No, that's actually the last two maps of the map pool. But either way, Rui being actually pressured quite heavily, Mafu up to 90 charge, able to help take him down with the help of him. He's not really a chance you're going to survive off of this one, and so far, it's just a bloodbath. I think Helsinki Reds, I think it stands for the blood that they're bleeding currently in this match, because NIP are just walking all over them.
Well, one thing that Hex brings up a lot when we talk about NIP, and it's very true here, is that NIP is one of the most aggressive teams in the game. They go out of their way to take fights on their terms, and the only way of dealing with it is to engage on them before they engage on you. But difficult task to do indeed, and look at how well set up NIP is for this next fight here, Jason.
I mean, I can only give like some criticism just because of the fact that you have Zappas on the low ground instead of the high ground, but I mean, the Graviton Surge and the way NIP are playing right now, they're allowed to get away with maybe some missteps or misplays in this kind of situation. But again, he's staying close to his team, which makes it a little bit harder for Exceed to take him down. And they get another pretty much solid wipe here. So, Helsinki Reds, and they go back to the drawing board. 20% left to go here on this first point. And with the Nano Visor already ready to go, I don't know if they're going to have what it takes to take this point back.
They do have at least somewhat equivalent resources here, but it's going to be difficult. This is their final shot of turning this round around, or they will be losing this round. But here we go. Pretty Wise coming in with the Groudon Surge. Going to pull in two immediately. Sets up Lumera for that big bang. Lumera gets Himsey from that. Only kill here thus far. We have a Nailbuster Tracer who's immediately taken out by 76. Zappas coming in there does not care about how charged up your Tracer is. And the rest of NIP able to swarm in and finish off the last few remaining kills. So initiation coming out here from the side of Reds, not going to be enough.
And just doesn't seem like Mafu even cares about having any health, because he's sat in about 20 HP for the longest time in that fight, even blocking out the Earth Shatter, for himself at least, with his own personal shield. And that'll be the first point of Ilias going over to NIP. Now, let's be blunt here, ZP, because I feel like we're in a situation where we should NIP going to be over on the blue side. And it looks like Helsinki Reds on the red. And to go honest for you guys who might not be familiar with these players, for the Helsinki Reds, we got BBR playing Lucio, Exceed on Pharah. We've got Ruape over on Reinhardt, Epix on Ana, Prettywise on Zarya, and Woomera on Tracer.
All right, well, we do have the first kills of this first fight getting underway. Zappas finally able to get the better of Exceed and gets Ana right at the same time. So two kills from Zappas, and he's going to be the main driving force there. Ends up at four before it's all said and done. It was a really long back and forth of poking here, though. Both teams really taking their time. And finally, Zappas able to thread the needle and get what he's looking for. And that is my cell phone alarm going off. So Jason, take it away.
It sounds beautiful. But either way, we did actually have this matchup happen yesterday, though, in the upper bracket finals, where we took pretty much just three games is all it took for NIP to take this victory against the Helsinki Reds. It was Route 66, Hollywood, and Lijiang Tower. We will be seeing Lijiang Tower and Route 66 in the map pool yet again. But that's more towards the end. Should be. NIP are probably considered hands down the favorites in this series. The fact that you've already seen them play once against each other, NIP is also one of the best European teams. And teams have not been able to figure out how to beat NIP necessarily. But if we were to look on the side of Helsinki Reds, where would you kind of put the effort to be in? Like, who would need to really have a standout performance here?
Well, I think certainly to deal with NIP, normally for teams you'd say, oh, just have a better DPS game. I think it's more on their tanks right now, where you're going to have to put it on players like Ruop and Pretty Wise to have the tank games of their lives and deal with how aggressive and how in-your-face the NIP tanks are. The NIP is defined by their tank game, and we saw in part in that last round just how aggressive they can be in setting up the rest of their team.
Well, we do have the Widow v Widow battle at least coming in here between Mafu and Exceed, which we did have Exceed do just earlier on and yesterday up against NC Esports, but neither Widowmaker has really been able to connect.